all of the noxious weed work that we have been going on in the state of Idaho and around the West is important to preserve the wildland ecosystems that we have. The ARRA, you know, opportunities that those funds have given to the counties, you know, allows them to put an additional emphasis in trying to control the noxious weed programs that they have.
I started treating weeds about the 1st of April, and this crew has been jumping from job to job, helping many landowners, private, a few state, and a couple county areas, and catching up on a lot of our noxious weeds that otherwise would have been poorly treated or not treated at all. So to me, this has been a great thing to catch up on some of these noxious weeds that our small crew is overwhelmed with.
This is a Scotch thistle. This is one of the most problematic thistles that we have in this area, partially because it's so big and so obnoxious, and these will take over a land area, and with the viability on the seed of 5 to 7 years from the time they drop, you're battling this plant for a minimum of 5 years just to get rid of it once it encroaches upon your land. So it really creates a dilemma as far as safety for the general public, being a noxious weed, usurping land that other animals and people are using for livelihood, production. It's just detrimental in so many different ways.
In areas like this where we have a mixed vegetation of rangelands and moving into riparian and forest lands, controlling the noxious weeds is very important, both from an ecosystem standpoint as well as preventing changing these types into vegetation types to become more susceptible to wildland fires and things of that nature.
Whenever you get noxious weeds in an area, they grow in such a tight group that it increases that volatility for fire, because there's so much of a plant that has the same flammability in one area. So it intensifies a fire as it goes through, and like the Scotch, you know, once they mature and seed out, they die and they're one big dry timber. They are not like some little plant that you snip off because you don't like it or spray it down. These things literally turn into timbers with 3-4 inch bases on them, 10-12 feet tall. So because they grow in such a tight-knit community, you increase your fire hazard and your combustibility in that area by not controlling that weed.
You know, state and private forestry, we couldn't have done it without Forest Service assistance, funding from the top down. There's just no way.
I think it's an absolutely wonderful project. It's put a lot of the local people to work, and it has also helped the local businesses, because everything that we have purchased for the supplies, we tried to do everything locally. So it has really increased, you know, commerce in the community. Plus it's, you know, given these people who are out of work jobs. So it's been great.
I was unemployed off and on for about 3 years, and it's benefited me because I got 2 kids and I can finally pay the bills. So it helps. I basically took the job so I could pay the bills. It's turned out to be something I like.
Yeah, I was unemployed. We just adopted a 2-year-old son, and we had trouble making payments, and now we're getting kind of back on track, starting to get bills paid and almost seeing daylight.